Okay. The information I'm going to give you is preliminary and subject to change. During this briefing, we'll provide a summary of what we know at this time, what we believe at this time. We'll take a few questions. Later on this evening, we'll provide a written brief. If you have any questions, please send those to the IMPD Public Affairs account. We'll try to answer questions. And then we expect to have another update tomorrow within 24 hours, less than 24 hours from the time of the incident. First of all, I'd like to start off by thanking members of our community, the outpouring of support that we've had so far for our officer and other officers on scene here. I want to thank Indianapolis Fire Department, IEMS, Indiana State Police, Eskenazi, all of these individuals, groups, organizations have provided tremendous help to us this evening. What we know at this time, on Sunday, February 27th, 2022, last night, shortly after 10 p.m., an officer with Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department was shot, and an officer-involved shooting occurred in the alley north of 1600 Woodlawn Avenue. Shortly after 10 p.m., IMPD Southeast District officers responded to a report of an accident in the 1600 block of Lexington Avenue. While officers were on the way, dispatch provided additional information to those officers. That information included that a black male in a red jacket was exposing himself, a male in a red vehicle was acting strange, and the male in the red vehicle was intoxicated and was last seen southbound on State Street. Officers located a red Buick and a male wearing a red jacket and a red vehicle in the 1600 block of Woodlawn Avenue. Two officers, both were in a fully marked police vehicle. Both were in full police uniform, engaged with the male. Within seconds, the male began running away from officers. The officers told the man, "Stop police." There was an exchange of gunfire between at least one officer and the suspect in the area of the alley north of 1600 Woodlawn Avenue. One IMPD officer was shot and was transported to Eskenazi Hospital by IMS in serious condition. Thankfully, that officer's condition has been upgraded to serious but stable condition. IMPD officers and Indiana State Police set up a perimeter to search for the suspect. IMPD Special Weapons and Tactics Team officers located the suspect shortly after 11 p.m. in the area of 900 Dawson Street. The suspect had injuries consistent with a gunshot wound or wounds. A handgun was located adjacent to where the suspect was located. Medics assigned to the SWAT team provided medical treatment to the suspect. The suspect was then transported by IEMS to Methodist Hospital and was most recently listed in critical condition. No other officers or citizens besides the one I mentioned were injured during this incident to our knowledge. Multiple officers were wearing body-worn cameras, which were activated at the time of the incident. The IMPD Critical Incident Response Team responded and will conduct a criminal investigation. The Internal Affairs Unit will conduct a parallel an independent administrative investigation into the actions that took place tonight. The Indianapolis Marion County Forensic Services Agency is assisting with this investigation. The IMPD Chaplains and Victims Assistance Office responded to provide assistance to individuals involved and their families and members of the community. The Police Officer Support Team responded to provide peer support to our officers. The Marion County Prosecutor's Office is on scene and is being consulted throughout the investigation. The officer who fired his gun has been placed on administrative leave as a standard protocol during any type of incident such as this. The Civilian Majority Use of Force Review Board will conduct a mandatory hearing for any use of deadly force against a person. This occurs after the conclusion of the criminal investigation. Detectives continue to canvass the area to attempt to locate witnesses, any video evidence, any forensic evidence. We expect to be out here for several hours. As I mentioned, I gave you several locations of scenes, so it's a very expansive crime scene. Detectives and officers will be out here for several hours to collect and identify evidence and collect that evidence. Anyone with information about this incident is asked to call the Critical Incident Response Team Detective Sergeant Leslie Van Buskirk at 327-3475, or they can email her at leslie.vanbuskirk@indy.gov. That spelling will all be in the briefing that we'll provide later. Also, Anyone that wants to remain anonymous can call Crime Stoppers at 262-TIPS. I know I give a lot of information. It might be a little bit confusing, so I'll try to clarify any questions that you have.
Foley, the alleged shooter, was he the person exposing himself or the person alleged in the red vehicle? Who was the alleged shooter in this incident?
So the alleged shooter was the person that the officers located in the red jacket and the red vehicle, which matched the description of the person who was exposing himself.
Have you had a chance, I'm going to wait for this truck to pass. Have you had a chance to see any of the body-worn camera to indicate what may have provoked this person to shoot at the officers?
I have seen the body camera footage. At this point, we're not going to release any other information about what was on the body camera footage. That way the detectives can review that and speak with witnesses, and that information doesn't influence them.
Shane, can you kind of explain it? So they came initially for a call of someone exposing themselves, and then there was...
Yeah, let me clarify that. So the initial call was for an accident, actually.
Okay, so they got a call for
an accident. And while they were on their way to this accident, they received additional information that a person was exposing himself, that was possibly intoxicated, was acting strange, and that person left going southbound on State, and then located the person matching that description further south at Woodlawn.
Okay. And that person was in a red Buick.
Correct.
Lieutenant, what does this say about, obviously, no traffic stop, no call for service is routine. The officers have to be prepared for anything. Can you just give us an indication? Well, you can't give us much information as to what training was put into place in this call.
Our officers are trained to handle rapidly evolving situations very quickly. And I think, as we saw with Aaron Allen, whose killer was convicted last week, something as simple as a traffic accident can result in shots fired and an officer being killed. Thankfully, at this point, our officer is in serious but stable condition, still receiving medical treatment. But we never know what's going to happen. Show up to a report of an accident, and at some point, there's an exchange of gunfire.
And so the man that was leaving, they told him to stop, and then there was the exchange of gunfire, and that's when the officer was shot, correct?
The man that was running away from the officers.
Yes, and that is the man. Do they think that is the man also that was exposing himself?
That's going to be part of the investigation.
Okay.
What we wanted to do is share as much information of the individual who matched the description. For me to say definitively that was the same person,
okay,
is a little bit too early on in the investigation.
But do we think he fired first?
So what we can say is there was an exchange of gunfire, and detectives certainly are going to explore how that exchange occurred.
And to be clear,
we'll take one more, guys.
There was no accident at all that they encountered, the officers?
So, interesting, we believe there was an accident that occurred at the Lexington. Let me make sure I have the address correct. Lexington Avenue. But that's still something that we're trying to verify. That's not where the officers located the suspect.
And that was so we think that might be totally unrelated, though, this accident.
But it's related to this investigation, because that's what brought the officers to this location. So there was a report of an accident. Officers responded there, and information they received in connection with this reported accident is what led officers to where this incident occurred.
What do you tell your families tonight, sir? You have a number of IMPD families that are on shift. Another shift will begin shortly. What do you tell those folks that are preparing to come into work and are wondering tonight, what the hell is going on?
Well, I think we've seen the resolve of our officers. You know, we have one officer who was shot, possibly multiple officers who were shot at, and everybody else is here. They're still taking, there's officers all across the city that are still taking runs. They're still serving the community of Indianapolis. And despite the adversity that our officers in this community have faced in the last year or more, our officers are still showing up every day, serving the community, and putting their lives at risk, just like what happened tonight, to make this community safe.
And
thank you.
Thank
you.
The body found in the alley,
sorry,
the person shot.
He says, we'll be having the written brief